Iran is one of the most dangerous places in the world for Christians. But that's exactly where the Swedish government intends to send these former Muslims. Their request for asylum that could save their lives, denied.
The Swedish government's attitude toward Iranian Christians facing deportation would seem to be as cold as the Swedish winter. The Iranians say Sweden's immigration board simply does not care that they may face prison or torture if they're returned to Iran.
Reza Jabari has been in hiding after his asylum request was rejected. He knows what awaits him in Iran.
In the Islam, it's Sharia. If every Muslim man who leaves the Islam must be killed because this man is apostate.
His pastor, Kai Berger, still can't believe Reza's asylum request was denied.
And I thought, this should be a piece of cake. I mean, this man has brought other Muslims to the Christian faith and the Christian baptism. I mean, if he's a fraud, he's a very bad one. He's bringing people to a Christian faith, but still they denied him. That made me look into what is going on.
What's going on, according to veteran Swedish immigration lawyer Gabriel Donner, is a badly run asylum process and in some cases, anti-Christian bias.
When you apply for asylum, you have to present your case. If you claim that you are a convert, you need to show some evidence of having converted. A certificate of baptism, for example, membership in a congregation, or something else of that sort.
But Donner says that crucial evidence is often missing from asylum applications because too many state-appointed lawyers don't include it, leaving the asylum seekers at the mercy of immigration officials who may not understand Swedish law, what it means to be a Christian, or how dangerous Iran is.
All of this together results in a sort of lottery, where some people win and some people lose.
Some of the losers are Ali, his wife Matab, and their little girl Serena. They're Iranian Christians who left Islam and they now face deportation.
We have told our families in Iran that we are Christian now, and they have disowned us. So we don't have a family to return to. Our blood is now halal. It's holy for Muslims to kill us.
Matab says a Swedish immigration official actually tried to comfort her by saying yes, they probably would be thrown into an Iranian prison, but not killed. Homera is another Iranian Christian facing deportation.
My asylum request was denied, and I was ordered to leave the country. I don't have any identity. I can't even use medical services.
She's in hiding and says when she tried to testify about her Christian faith to immigration officials, they thought she was lying.
Officials do not seem to understand why a Muslim would become a Christian. They asked me, why didn't you become a Jew?
Reza Jabari says an immigration official told him that when he's deported to Iran, all he needs to do is tell everyone he's a Muslim, not a Christian, and he'll be fine.
I'm saying, after I'm baptized, and I'm a Christian. You cannot say like these things to me.
There's a lot of bias regarding Christian converts because the standard argument is, well, nobody converts to Christianity out of true belief. Why would anybody do anything of a sort?
They are ignorant about religious issues. They don't know the difference between a Catholic church or Pentecostal. They ask a lot of stupid questions about Christian faith.
Bengt Schoberg spends his time trying to rescue Christian asylum seekers.
Almost every week, about five or six churches call me and say, these people who have come to church, they are real converts. They are members in our church, but Migration Board, they don't believe they are Christians. What shall we do?
Mikael Ribbenvik, director of operations for the Swedish Migration Board, describes an agency that seems to be overwhelmed by asylum seekers.
And we have about 1,000 people coming every week from all countries of the world, or many countries of the world. And so that's our first challenge. Then, of course, we have to have a proper procedure and give people answers in due time. If we say no, you can go to the courts. But, of course, the volume in the system is a challenging task for us.
But it shouldn't be hard for Swedish officials to understand that Iran is a very dangerous place for Christians. The case of Pastor Yusuf Nardakani brought worldwide attention. when he was convicted of apostasy and sentenced to death before being acquitted. Just a few weeks ago in Washington, a congressional hearing heard from Iranian Christian Nagma Abedini, whose husband, Pastor Saeed Abedini, an American citizen, has been given an 8-year prison sentence for threatening Iran's national security. He was building an orphanage.
He was in prison because he loved Jesus.
Pastor Saeed's attorneys say his client's 8-year sentence amounts to death. He's already been tortured and beaten in prison and has internal bleeding. Reza was a famous singer in Iran and refused to help the Islamic regime, getting him in trouble before and making him an even bigger target if he's sent back.
He's been put in prison. They tried to recruit him as an informant. We don't know what's going to happen to him in prison. Is he being tortured? Is he being left alone? We don't know this.
But these Christians all told us they've given their situations to God.
Jesus, accept me. And now I'm very free.
We asked Sweden's migration board if it understood the danger faced by Christian converts sent back to Iran. It said it did. Donner said that makes what Sweden is doing to these asylum seekers all the more damning. The government of Sweden seems to have closed its eyes. Bengt Sjöberg says when he told a Swedish migration board official that a family they deported was being tortured, the official said the family should call the police. When Sjöberg explained that they were being tortured by the police, the official hung up.
The history books will say something pretty nasty about Sweden's policy in this matter in the future.
Dale Hurd, CBN News, Stockholm.